It's got this special touch. Ding.
Okay, and when was the first time you heard her sing?
Some years back. I heard her in a different band that she used to sing in, and we also once we made a song together. Before the Astros Galaxy tour, like 2 years before, we made a song which actually became Around the Bend today.
Okay.
And we worked on that song and just as a project and to see if there was something there, but we were both too busy at that time.
Yeah, doing other stuff.
Yeah. So we thought Around the Bend can wait.
Yeah.
And then 1 or 2 years went by and I was like, I miss Mette.
It tickled him, yeah. That song.
And I had been writing other songs in that same kind of vein, and it was obvious to me that Mette would be the singer. I mean, all female singers are, no, not all, but many female singers have this annoying thing that they sound so trained and schooled, like they've been taking too many singing lessons. Mm-hmm. Instead of just sounding honest and pure and energetic, it's all about their technique, and I think that's such a shame, and it keeps many female singers especially from sounding truly unique, like Dylan or Mick Jagger or Damon Albarn or whoever, you know, they don't really sing, they can't really sing, but in a way they're really the best singers ever. I think Mette's got that quality too, even though she can actually sing.
Mm-hmm.
With a nice technique and everything.
I can actually
But I run screaming out of the bus every time she does it.
Yeah.
It's the most natural thing for you is just to...
Give me the face, give me the face.
I'm spilling my coffee.
Well, she's a very good singer, you said, and as a songwriter, because you're, I think, writing the most songs, or all the songs.
As I said, some of the songs were made already when we started out.
Mm-hmm.
I presented these songs to Mette, but they were more like rough sketches or ideas, and we started to build on top of these ideas, and the new ideas and beats came along, and we built on top of that. So it's also a collaborative effort, but I mean most of the songs, I guess, was started out by me, but it's you can't really, I mean, you can't take the two things apart. It's because I wouldn't be able to write these songs if it wasn't for Mette's voice and inspiration that she gives me. And Mette's got, I mean, there's always stuff that Mette's changing, like melody lines or hook lines or lyrical stuff. Like, I don't really like this kind of way of saying it. Why don't we do it like this? So it always becomes Mette's song. Okay. I think.
And Mette?
We talked a lot about me now. I got all shy.
What's the personal attraction you got towards towards Lars?
The personal attraction.
What was the main thing that you thought, okay, I can work with him?
I think the main thing was that that Lars is a really great producer. He's got this special touch, you know, he's got great ears and he can create something in his mind, and he's actually capable and really good at getting it out and creating it. If we talk about music, we understand each other. If I say something, try to explain a sound or a feeling, then he knows what I say, and that's a really nice thing when you work together, that you understand each other. Or say, oh, I want it more like be more rare, and then he knows what I mean, or the opposite. And that was one of the first thing that attracted me to that. You know, we're friends, and we were friends before we played, but he's really, really a great musician.